this morning, and I just want to thank God for your life, because I know that God has connected us in this hour of prayer again. And I want you to pick up your phone wherever you are. Some of you watching us from Africa, pick up your phone and connect your neighbor, your loved ones, and your friends. Connect them, because I know that today, definitely, there is nothing that is going to stop the blessings of God in your life and for your life except yourself. And the Bible says that where two or three are gathered talking about the Lord, that is right there in their midst. And we are operating in a higher level of the operation of the things of God. You see, the gospel has also gone digital. We're living in the end time. We're living in the world of media and digital. And so this morning, we're going to have a digital prophetic prayer. And I believe that God is going to touch your life. And what do I mean by that? You see, God has taken the pulpit from the church and taken it out to the digital world, and taking it out to the media world. So both, everything working together because of you. God has a great purpose for our time and this season that we're in, because the Bible says that the time, at the fullness of the time of the Gentiles. Very, very important. And we are living at the fullness of time according to God's purpose. In Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 1, it says, "For everything that is under the heavens, there is a season and a time that affects that of that purpose for which God has instituted or is moving or is doing something." And I want you to know your life has a purpose. And this moment we're in has a purpose in your life. And guess what? It is not by accident that you tune in to this program. No, at all. And I know that quite a lot of you have been expecting. You've been saying, "Okay, look, listen. Somehow you couldn't sleep. Somehow you just woke up. Somehow something kept you awake." Because God's purpose for your life has to be fulfilled. You see, when Saul's father's donkeys got missing, it was a natural thing that it looks like. But there is a spiritual reason for that. And that, the Bible says, they went seeking for those donkeys for 3 days. And the third day, they met with Samuel. And the previous day, God told Samuel, he said, "By this time tomorrow, I will bring the man that you were anointed to be captain over my people." You see, God using natural things to bring us to the place of purpose and to the place of destiny. So the same thing this morning, because I believe there is no mistake. God has orchestrated me and kept me and, you know, brought me here to connect with you. And God has also done the same thing in your life. That's why you couldn't sleep. That's why you wanted to go out. You couldn't go out. That's why you find yourself, every channel you try to tune into, but you just stick to this one. Because God wants you to be part of what we are doing right now. And God is taking the pulpit and brought it right into your home. Maybe there are things that he's going to speak to you, confirm things in your life. But whatever it is, make the most of it. Because God has a plan. And that plan, don't let it be wasted. That purpose, don't let it be wasted. Understand your time of visitation. My name is Bishop Joel Oluwafemi. And by the grace of God, I'm the Bishop of Kingdom Life Prophetic Ministries here in London and across the nations of the world. And God has used me to pioneer the night prayer. And it's so exciting to know that 10 years to this very year, it makes it 10 years plus now that I have been empowered, commissioned, anointed, and continue in this work of the ministry on media, dealing with digital and media devils. It's not a joke, let me tell you, because the Bible says, you see, Paul the Apostle says something that is so exciting in his days. Now, he knew that the prince of the power of air operates And now when you are dealing with the prince of the power of the air, you are talking about media, you are talking about digital, you are talking about internet, you are talking about anything that is communicating. It moves in the power of the air. And so Paul the apostle, by the Holy Spirit, he said, the prince of the power of the air that walks in the spirit of them that disobey, the children of disobedience, he walks in them. So you've got to deal with such things in your life, such things in the nation, such things in our community, such things in our culture, in order to allow the plan and purposes of God to come to pass. And so, get ready this morning. We're going to have a session of prayer. And I have with me, you know, a man of God and a woman of God. And we're going to together share and also together minister the word of the living God and pray. So when the time for prayer, the one that you can call in for your request, the studio line will be open. But get your Bible. Get your writing materials. Get your pen. Some of the things you'll be hearing, the Spirit of God will stir you up for the topic of your prayer or your prayer point. And then before we come to now open the studio line and pray for you. So here with me this morning on this prophetic hour is a woman of God. I start first with her on my right. And you are woman of God?
Yes, my name is Elodie Mutanda.
Elodie Mutanda. From which nation is that?
She's from the Congo.
Oh, wow. So we're dealing with Congo devils, the Congolese devils, the French devils also. We've got to deal with them. You know, I mean, that is what I understand. There are community devils, there are local devils, there are national devils, there are international devils.
That's right.
And every level of those devils, God has given us authority to deal with them.
Amen.
That's why he said, behold, I give unto you power to tread upon serpents. Some of them are walking in the level of serpental spirit. And then I give unto you power to tread upon serpent and upon scorpion. Some are scorpion power. You deal with them. And then some are English devils. We deal with them. So wherever we find ourselves by the operation of the Holy Spirit in us, he calls us to do great things. So you are welcome. You ready for prayer?
Yes, sir.
Amen and amen. Well, man of God, I want to thank God for your life. If you look at the camera and let us your name and your details.
Oh, my name is Gabriel Adewuyega Odushina. I'm the pastor of the Voice of God Church, London. And I know God is going to do great things in your life today as you are watching. In the mighty name of Jesus. Change is coming. Turn around is coming. Breakthrough is coming. Deliverance is coming in Jesus' mighty name.
Praise God. Well, today I know we have a lot of prayer points and issues to touch about. So if you want to share with us some of the things that you will have in mind today.
Praise the Lord. Today I want to give you keys to turning around hopeless situations. I don't know, as you are lying down there, you can't sleep, you are troubled, maybe you are in the mood of prayer because you have a burden or you have burdens upon your heart. Listen to me, there is hope. Amen. Because the Lord, our God, our Master, King, and Creator, he said he will never leave us nor forsake us. The Bible says that my people perish because they lack knowledge. It is the knowledge that you don't have that's the problem. There is no problem too big for our God. That's why God has sent us to give you the solutions to that problem, to share knowledge with you and to help you. He said we should be our brother's keeper, and he said iron sharpeneth iron. Amen. So we are here to sharpen some people today. And because the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, and because he has anointed me to preach the good tidings unto the meek and to the poor, because he has anointed me to release those that are in prison, the anointing of God upon my life, it breaks every yoke. You know, today we had a wonderful session and the Lord moved mightily. I'm still feeling charged now. Amen. And I know that that same presence of God that was present in that meeting will come and meet you in your home right now, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Yeah, well, man of God, let's because I know that at this time, to some nations, they have already advanced in the day.
Yes.
To some, they are just preparing to sleep. I have friends in America who are watching us, and it's just the evening, they're just getting ready to sleep.
Okay.
We know we are in summertime in London. Mm-hmm. Very soon, the days break and things like that. Now, what is, when you talk about some of the things you are saying now, what are the issues that keep people awake, that they can't sleep, they can't get, to do
now,
the things that they need to do?
People, I mean, maybe some people have slept, they woke up because of nightmares, I have nightmares. Witches are chasing me, I see masquerades, I see things, you see different type of creatures chasing you and you can't sleep and you are scared. Fear not. Maybe you have financial problems. Fear not. Maybe it is the issue of your normalizing your stay. Fear not. Solution is coming. There's a word of God. Whatever the situation or the circumstances is, there's a word of God meet for that situation. The word of God is like a key. When you have that key, it opens every door. He said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life.
Yes, man of God. Now, because I believe what you are saying is very correct. Especially that the Bible says that the weapons of our warfare
are not carnal,
but they are mighty. So if the Bible talk about weapons, it means that there are different kinds of weapons for different kinds of situations. Now, the situations that we want to deal with today, what is the main scripture that the Lord has given to you to deal with such specific situation?
Now, the first thing I will tell you as you are looking at me, child of God, first question I will ask you is, do you know him? Because there is somebody, he is the unchanging changer. Amen. He is the creator of the universe. He is the one that has a name above all other names. He is the one that has a power above all powers. You see, the book of Hebrews, chapter 11, verse 6, says, without faith, it is impossible to please God. Amen?
So we're dealing with faith to deal with that, or
now,
the call? Because, you see, the way that we ministers can better help people, it's like when a doctor, you come to see a doctor.
To prescribe.
Now, he sees you, and then he says, they ask you what your problem is, and then you prescribe a specific, medication that will be dealt with, that can deal with that situation.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, now, that's where I'm going.
I'll give you,
that people at home.
I'll give you what is called a general antibiotics.
Mm-hmm.
So Psalm 48, verse 1 to 2. It says, he is beautiful for all situations.
Okay.
No matter what the situation is, there is a word of God meet for that situation. God can turn any situation around. And that is why today I want to give you keys. No matter what the situation is, there is a word of God. There is a promise of God meet for that situation that will turn it around.
Amen.
Amen? If you can believe that word, it will work for you. Amen. The word of God is a weapon. It's a sword on itself. That is the sword of the spirit. When the Lord Jesus was facing Satan, he did not, argue. He did not cry. He just said, it is written. I was telling them this.
So that's exactly what I'm saying. So he picked a scripture to deal specifically with that situation.
Yes.
So when we are dealing with night prayer, this is where we go. He said the scripture says this. If you are going through this, the Bible says this. And then we can take it as a prayer and as an authority, the ground on which we are dealing with that devil. Because you see, demonic forces work with what we call what is known as a legal ground.
Yeah.
The devil cannot operate in your life or fight you without a legal ground.
Yeah.
He's got to have a legal ground, something that he hold on to. That's why the Lord Jesus Christ said, the prince of this world coming, but he found nothing in me. So when he comes, he looks at the legal ground on which he can deal with you. Now, if he finds no legal ground, then his power is powerless. Then when you speak and say, no, this is what the Lord said, thus says the Lord, oh, it is written, he responds to it. And that's a very good example you gave. Because in the wilderness, when the devil said, if you are the Son of God, turn these stones to bread. He brought up the scripture. It is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Yes, man of God.
The first thing I will add now is, you see, who can actually, you know, because everybody, you know, wants the help of God. But my Bible makes me to understand that our God, the God that we serve, does not listen, okay, to the prayers of a sinner. So as you are looking at me right now, you might be, you know, worried and depressed. I just want you to pray. Because you see, you cannot receive a gift without receiving the giver of that gift. So I want you now, if you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ, if you're a backslider, you want, no matter what, he said, come unto me. Even if your sin be like crimson, I'll make it white as snow. So I want you to be reconciled to the giver of the gift. The Bible says in the book of Ephesians that he has given gifts. As we are sitting down here, we are gifts to you. The fivefold ministry are gifts to the body of Christ. Well, if you cannot receive us without receiving him that has sent us. So I want you to first reconcile with him that has sent us first. And say, Lord Jesus, I have sinned. I have come short of the glory of God. That blood that was shed on Calvary, let it wash me first. Lord, let that blood wash me. I repent of my sins. Let a garment of righteousness be put upon me. Forgive me of my sins. And let me be justified. Amen? When you are justified, it's as if you never sinned. Then you can come before the presence of God. I want to read a scripture to you that will buttress what I'm saying. I want to read from Psalm 24, verse 3. It said, who shall ascend unto the hill of the Lord? Or who shall stand in his holy place? So before you can even go before God and ask for help, and expect his deliverance, and expect him to come to your aid, you must first forsake your sins first. So who shall ascend unto the hill of the Lord? Who shall stand in his holy place? He that has clean hands and a pure heart, who has not lifted up his soul unto vanity, nor sworn deceitfully, he shall receive the blessing from the Lord, and righteousness from the God of his salvation. This is the generation of them that seek him, and seek thy face, O Jacob. Amen. So I want you to speak to that God and say, Lord, I am sorry. Jesus is the only way. There is no other name in heaven and on earth by which a man can be saved. Amen. Ask him to come into your life. Say, Lord, forgive me of my sins and come into my life. You then have the grace to call him Father. Amen. I want you to go with me to the verse 7 of that scripture. After you have done that, you have reconciled yourself with him. He now said, lift up your heads, O ye gates. Be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. No matter what you are going through right now, no matter what the spiritual battle is, there is a God that is mighty in battle. And as you have reconciled yourself to him, he will fight your battles for you. And you shall be victorious this morning. Or whatever time it is where you are, victory is yours this morning because you're on the winning side once you're on the side of the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. Now, I'm going to go back to this scripture again. It says, lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors. It does not matter. I can hear. Sometimes you are praying and they'll say, who has done such in your family? You are praying God for breakthrough. You want to move forward. You want to prosper in life. Oh, you've been in this country or whatever country you are living in, and you want to normalize your stay, but it has been impossible because nobody has achieved such success in your family. Some people, you know, you want to start your own business. You can't even point to any entrepreneurs in your family. You want to do great things, but, you know, your life is limited. There's a limitation upon your life. I'm speaking the word of God to you now. I want you to open your Bible to Psalm 24, verse 7, and you begin to declare, lift up your heads, O ye gates, that door that has been shut against your life, that door that has been shut against your destiny, at this moment, at this hour, that gate will move. Because you are not asking that gate to move in your name. Amen. Listen to that scripture. Say, lift up your heads, O ye gates. Be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. One of the greatest keys to receiving breakthroughs in life is the presence of God. If you can find yourself in the presence of God, oh boy, then you are blessed. Why? Because in his presence there is liberty. It is not possible for any parent for your child to be in your presence and that child is tied up. Even if it is a chicken, that chicken will fight to death. Amen. So when you are in the presence of your father, there is no power in heaven. Lift up your heads, ye everlasting gates, you powers of darkness that have withstood my parents, that made my parents never to prosper, that made my parents never to break through. They said they delay in getting married in your family. There's always a delay in getting married in your family. It has become a norm in your family. It's like, oh, you know, in our family, they don't get married early enough. Today, you are going to pray. Amen. You are going to ask those everlasting. They have been there for long, but today, that yoke will be broken. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus, we are not breaking it in my name. We are breaking it in the name of the Most High God and by the sword of the Spirit. Amen. He said, be ye lift up, O ye gates. Be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors. They have been there of old. But today, because of the King of glory, because he's standing by you, he's going to walk with you through that gate. They won't open because of you. They will open because of the King of glory, because of his presence. Doors open. I'll tell you another story. The man, Peter, you see, they helped Peter and they put him in jail. And when the brethren begin to pray, because of the presence of the Lord. The Lord came with his angels. The angels stabbed him and said, Peter, get up. Can't you? The master is here. The master of the whole universe. When Peter woke up, the chains broke away. Now, what surprises me about that scripture is that the gates flung open by themselves. The gates did not fling open because of Peter, but because of the presence of the Most High God. I'll show you another scripture quickly. I want us to go to Psalm 97, verse 5. That's a powerful scripture, Psalm 97, verse 5. So you are looking at me right now, you say, oh, my own problem is too much. They have given me a deportation letter. Oh, my own problem is too much. I have looked for a job I could not find. My own problem is too much. There is problem in the home. Everything has turned upside down. There is no peace. This mountain is too high for me. Listen, stop telling God how big your problem is. Stop telling God how big your mountain is. Start telling that mountain how big your God is.
Amen.
Now, Psalm 97, verse 5, if you find it, it said, the hills, they melt like wax at the presence of the Lord, and at the presence of the Lord of the whole earth. He is the Lord of the whole earth. He said, the heavens declare his righteousness, and his people see his glory. My prayer is that this morning you will see the glory of God. You will meet with the mercy of God. There will be a turnaround and a change in your life in this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. I don't care what the situation or the circumstances, but at the name of Jesus this morning, that circumstance, that situation will melt like wax because of the presence of God. I feel his presence so mightily right now. And I pray that his presence come upon you right now as you are looking at me. Let his presence come into your home right now. All those monitoring spirits in your home, I bind them in the mighty name of Jesus. And I command them to go to the desolate wilderness right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Many of you, they have sent monitoring spirits. You think you are deceiving people back home. You are someone like me that came from Africa. You think because you ran away from Africa, they can't see you. But they are monitoring spirits. In the realm of the spirit, nothing is hidden. But right now, I send the word of God. Because the Bible says, at the sound of my voice, strangers, they must submit themselves unto me. And they must fade away from their hiding places. Wherever those strangers are hiding in your home, wherever they are hiding in your life, I command them to be bound now and to be removed now. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. I command those spirits that peep and mutter now. I command you to be blind, to be deaf and dumb now. I command you to go. Because the Spirit of God is upon me. Every yoke upon your life as you are looking at me, I decree to be broken now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Because the word of God is alive. It is active. It is sharper than any two-edged sword. I don't care what the plan of the enemy is. I don't care what the plan of your family members or your whoever is against you. Whoever is incensed against you. I have come with the word of God that is due for this season. Hallelujah. As you are listening to me now, I don't care. The word of God has been sent forth to reverse that curse. In the book of Galatians chapter 3 verse 13, he said Jesus became a curse for us because it is written, cursed is he that hangeth on a tree. I don't care who has spoken a negative word into your life this morning. I don't care what they have said. Even if it is your parents, even if it is your enemies, whether they have gone to a false altar, a false prophet, an idol worshiper, or a sorcerer, whether it's a witch, I don't care who has spoken that word. But the Bible says Jesus became a curse for you. In other words, this morning, that negative word that is active in your life, that is making things not to work right, I pray right now that that curse goes to the cross. Because Jesus died because of you. Amen. He became a curse because of you. The Bible now says so that the blessings of Abraham can come to you. What are the blessings of Abraham? In the book of Genesis chapter 12, the Lord told Abraham, he said, I will bless you. He said, I will make you great and I will make you a blessing. This morning, you are getting promoted. Amen. From a well to a river. From a well, from being self-sufficient to having more than enough to give to people, to help people. That is the level the Lord is taking you this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus. As you are looking at me, you are saying, how is this going to be possible? That is not your own. Don't worry about that. The Bible says, the Lord said, I have sent my word forth, and it shall not return unto me void, without accomplishing that which I have sent it. So you are looking at me this morning. The word of God has been sent out. Angels have been dispatched on your behalf, and they will not return until they have accomplished that which I have sent that word to do. I decree breakthrough for you right now. I decree liberty. Maybe you have been working hard and You you are not making any progress. Maybe there is a limitation upon your life. There is a limit upon every member of your family. Lift up all ye gates this morning. You everlasting gates, I command you to be removed this morning. That limitation that is upon your life, I command you to lift up now. Maybe everybody in your family, they are giving them the spirit of slavery. You just work and labor for people. You cannot be an entrepreneur. That grace, receive it this morning. You have been thinking of how you are going to start your own business. Just have faith in God. You see, because a woman came to the prophet, you know, and said, oh, my husband was one of the sons of the prophet. So in other words, her husband was serving the prophet, Prophet Elisha. And she said, he died and he left a debt. And they even want to come and take his sons. And the prophet said, oh, what have you got? He said, I've got some oil. And right there, she received the miracle. Hallelujah. Today, as you are hearing my voice, receive your miracle. If God has sent me, and I know the Lord called me and he anointed me because of you. He said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me.
Hallelujah.
The Spirit of the Lord that is upon a man of God is for the people. It's not for him. The Spirit of God that is for the man of God is the one within him. But the one that is upon me that is for you will work for you this morning. That anointing breaks yokes. That anointing brings turn around. That anointing changes seasons. In the mighty name of Jesus. That anointing changes destinies. Whatever the enemy has spoken concerning you, today I cancel it.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. I cancel it. It will not happen. I say the will of God for your life. That is what will happen. The Bible says for those he foreknew, those he predestinated. God has predestined your life. He has planned something concerning you. The Bible says the thoughts of God towards you are thoughts of good and not evil. To bring you to an expected end. I decree right now, I superimpose the spiritual on the physical right now. Whatever has been written concerning you in the realms of the spirit that is being blocked in the realms of men, I command, as it is written, that his kingdom will come. The kingdom of God will be enforced, will be empowered. Today there will be a coalition of kingdoms. I command that the host of heaven go to war right now concerning you as you are looking at me now. The host of heaven, I engage them in battle right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, and our victory is sure. As you are looking at me now, you are being delivered. Because you are in the presence of God. And I pray now that the presence of God comes into your living room. The presence of God comes into your bedroom now. Chains are being broken. You are being set free now. Chains are being broken. You are being released from that curse. You are being released from that limitation. You are being released right now by the Spirit of the living God. Breakthrough is coming. Deliverance is coming. You are being prospered. What the level anybody has not reached in your family before. Because of the word of God that is being released now. The Spirit of the Lord will accomplish it. Because the Bible says, God confirmed the words of his servants, the prophets.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So that word that I've spoken now has gone straight into your life right now. Whatever has been difficult for you before, whatever has been frustrating you that you have been struggling with, I command right now. Because it is written, he said the first Adam is a living soul. He said the last Adam is a quickening spirit. Maybe your life has been slow. Things have not been working. Today, the same power that raised Lazarus from the dead, the same power that raised the Lord Jesus from the dead, that resurrection power is coming into your life right now. It's turning your life around. Your life is changing. There is breakthrough now. There is transformation now. In the mighty name of Jesus. There is somebody looking at me. You've been looking for jobs. Jobs have not been coming because they have shut your heavens. I plead the blood of Jesus. That person that has been looking for jobs, I plead the blood of Jesus. Whatever the accuser has against you, that he has been saying, because of this, why should he prosper? Let the blood of Jesus right now wash away all those accusations right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. I break that yoke now. In the mighty name of Jesus. I say receive your job. In the mighty name of Jesus. You are going from searching for a job. Now the next challenge you are going to have is that you are going to have three jobs.
Hallelujah.
And you have to choose from one.
Hallelujah.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Makabasuntabaya. Lady, you are looking at me. You say you've been looking for the fruit of the womb. Hear me. The Bible says the fruit of the womb is a reward. Children are the heritage of the Lord. And the fruit of the womb is a reward.
Amen.
Child of God, hear me. Today, may the Lord remember you.
Amen.
May he remember all your good deeds. May he remember all your offerings, all the tithes that you have paid. May the book of remembrance be open concerning you right now. I go into the power of the Almighty God right now. That power of creation. By the power and the spoken word. Hear me now. I speak to that womb now. I don't care what the doctors have said. I don't care whether they said your ovary or your womb is not working. I go into the power of he that created you, that created that womb. Let there be a recreation right now. Whatever the enemy has destroyed, as you are listening to me now, you will feel fire on your head. You will feel fire in that womb now. I speak to that womb and receive life. Receive grace to conceal life, to retain life. You've been having miscarriages. That power that steals babies from your womb, I arrest that power now. I command the fire of the Holy Ghost to devour that spirit now. Receive your deliverance now. Receive your breakthrough right now. As you are listening to me, Manda Broka Yabasete. Aha. You are looking at me. You have labored and labored. You walk like an elephant, but you eat like an ant. Deliverance is coming your way now. In the mighty name of Jesus, I speak to the earth on your behalf now. I speak to the earth. No longer will you plant and you will receive thorns. In the mighty name of Jesus, I decree right now, I speak to the earth on your behalf. Whatever nation that you are living in and you are looking at me, I command the spirit of prosperity to come upon you. Listen to me. The Bible says it will confirm the covenants of the fathers. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Everywhere Isaac went, he prospered.
Amen.
Even in the wilderness, he dug a well, water came out.
Hallelujah.
It doesn't matter wherever you are. God can prosper you there.
Amen.
You don't need to move from point A to point B. When the grace and favor of God is upon you, oh God, wherever you are, you will prosper. When the favor of God is upon your life, you will be prospered.
Amen.
Kings will minister unto you. When the children of Israel, they were living in Egypt, the Lord put favor upon them. And the Egyptians just gave them all their precious jewelries. They just gave to them. All their gold, all their diamond, they gave it to them. As you are looking at me today, help eluded you. Today you will find help.
Hallelujah.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. The favor of God will come upon you. You will receive as you are listening to me now. Receive the favor of God and the favor of men. Everywhere your assigned helpers are. Anywhere your assigned helpers are. Right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, let them locate you. Let them locate you. Let them locate you. In the mighty name of Jesus. I don't want you to know what the problem is. Our God is above every other problem. In the mighty name of Jesus. Because I'm seated with him right now, above every principality. There's a caller on the line. Hello.
Hello, sir.
Yes, God bless you.
Yes, sir. Please, I want you to pray for me, sir.
What is your name, sir?
My name is Goke.
Okay. What do you want me to pray about, sir?
Yeah, I want breakthrough for my family and for my ministry, please.
And for your what?
My family and for my church.
And for your church. Oh, you are a servant of God, sir?
Yes, sir.
Oh, praise God. Praise God. Man of God, I join you in prayer right now.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus, Makayabo Sinta, Malikabruba Sinta Yaba. The Bible says the enemy comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. I pray right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I commit your servant into your hand. You are the caller of the called. You are the sender of the sent. Right now, I pray. Let his calling receive a quickening. Let the fire of God come upon you afresh.
Amen. Receive fresh oil now in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, I cover your son in the blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
I wash him spirit, soul, and body. Whatever yes. the enemy has against him, let it be washed away now. Father, I pray right now in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak breakthrough.
Amen.
I speak breakthrough in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the helpers of your calling, let them locate you right now.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus,
Amen.
Every door that has been shut against you, Amen. I command in the mighty name of Jesus, let them open by the Kayebo Sinta. By the reason of the anointing, I decree, let them open. I command. Let the angels that have been assigned to that ministry now, let them get to work now. I command, I order you back to work now. The angels that have been assigned to your ministry that have been idle, I decree right now that they go back to work in the mighty name of Jesus. Now I go to the realm of the spirit. I make a pathway for that ministry now. I command the heavens to open over that ministry now. I command the heavens to open over your home now in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak a turnaround and a change. In the mighty name of Jesus, I dispatch angels. Jesus said, those that are meant for me will come for they will come unto me. Every soul that the Lord has assigned to that ministry, let them locate you now. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. No longer will you catch small fishes.
Amen.
I decree, when you cast your net, you shall catch the golden fish.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray right now. Any form of disobedience, I pray that the Lord in his mercy will forgive you.
Amen.
And every crooked path will be made straight.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
It is the Lord's ministry, and he will build it himself. He said, I will build my church. Man of God, hear me. You have to rest in the Lord. Trust in the Lord.
Amen.
The Bible says, to everything upon the face of the earth, there's a time and there's a season.
Amen.
Don't play the horse and play the mule. You see, Abraham, he knew the Lord for many years. But the Bible says it was when he was 99, he began to walk with him. This is the time to begin to walk with God.
Amen.
It is time to begin to walk by his instructions.
Amen.
Not our will, but his will be done.
Amen.
Amen. And I pray, let the Lord glorify himself in you and through you. In the
Amen.
Mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Everything that the Lord has planted in you, I command them to be reactivated now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Those gifts, let them come alive now. Let them come alive now. Let there be a quickening in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every attack Amen. Of the enemy, I cancel them now. Aha. Any witchcraft activity, I bring that activity to an end now. I bind those spirits now. I bind them. I bring their oppressions to an end.
Amen.
You witches, powers of darkness that have been assigned Amen. Against him, his family,
Amen.
And his ministry, I bring Amen. Your workings to an end now.
Amen.
In the
Amen.
Mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I command the light of the Most High God. To shine right now. Let every darkness Amen. Depart.
Amen.
It shall be peace. From Amen. Today, it shall be joy.
Amen.
Every limitation upon your life and that ministry, I cancel it now.
Amen.
You are moving forward.
Amen.
You will move to the expand to the right and to the left.
Amen.
It is victory on every side from today.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
God bless you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
It is well with you in Jesus' mighty name.
We thank God tonight for this morning. Hallelujah.
You want to bless the people?
Hallelujah. I liked when you said, you know, the Lord has anointed me for you. Hallelujah.
Amen. There's another caller on the line. Hello, caller. Is there a caller on the line? Hello. Okay, go on.
Hello.
Hello. God bless you.
Hello, Pastor. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. It is well with you in Jesus' name.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, I can hear you.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. What's your name?
Oh, Jesus, the Lord God.
What is your name?
My name is Rose.
Okay, Rose. God bless you.
God bless you, sir.
Yes, what do you want the Lord to do for you?
I want an open heaven, sir.
You want open heavens.
I want an open heaven.
You want to open heavens? Who told you that your heavens are short? Mabashikatabosintabaya. I pray that you receive the favor of God and the favor of men in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
It is sins that make heavens too short. And you have been justified, so your heavens cannot be short. Amen.
Amen.
I just pray right now that your clouds be full of rain.
Amen.
And showers of refreshing begin to fall on you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray that the Lord gives you a second chance now.
Amen.
That's what I can hear. The Lord says I should tell you that he's giving you a second chance.
Thank you, Jesus.
Turn around and a change is coming to your life as you are listening to me now in the mighty name of Jesus. Everything that is not working in your life will begin to work now.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. The yokes are broken. The limitation over your life has been broken. The agents of the enemy that have been assigned to you, they have been arrested, you are free.
Amen.
Go and prosper.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Don't look back anymore.
Yes, sir.
Aha. Let the quickening spirit, that resurrection power of God, let it come and dwell in you now.
Amen.
Listen to me. Righteousness exalts a nation.
Yes, sir.
That's what I can hear. Righteousness exalts a nation. Stand before God in righteousness.
Yes, sir.
Amen. And it shall be well with you.
Amen, sir.
Receive the favor of God and the favor of men. In
Amen.
The mighty name of... From today, everything you touch is blessed.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Everything that you have struggled with before, everything that was not working, from now it will begin to work.
Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus.
Where they have forgotten you, they will remember you now. I release Amen. Your name in the realm of the spirits.
Amen.
Even the chief high priest himself will begin to make intercessions for you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, our Father and our God.
Thank you, Jesus.
It is well with you. Receive
Amen,
the spirit
sir.
Of fruitfulness.
Amen.
You will be fruitful in the mighty
Amen.
Name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray for you. It shall be well with you.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen, sir.
God bless you.
God bless you, sir.
It is well.
Bye-bye, sir.
God bless you. Mabasatayaba.
As I was saying earlier, I was so blessed when you said that the Lord has anointed you for the viewers that are watching us tonight. And
hello.
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 Good morning.
Good morning. God bless you.
Good morning.
Yes. God bless you, sir. I can hear you.
Am I sick on?
Sir?
Yes. Asking for my deputy.
I
want you to pray for us.
Yes.
In America, because they are going to have a big vote on Saturday. I don't want any problem in America and in general. Please help us to pray for we people in America. In the name of Jesus. God bless you.
Where are you calling from again?
Nigeria.
Hello? I pray in the mighty name of Jesus. That the Lord will intervene. Every power that causes unrest, every power of hell, we bind you in the mighty name of Jesus. It is the will of God that will be done. In the mighty name of Jesus, we superimpose the will of God in that area, in that community. I speak peace. I speak joy. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every blood, that's what I can hear now. Every blood sucking demon, I bind you in the name of Jesus. There will be no blood shed in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree to be so. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
It shall be well with you. God bless you.
Hallelujah.
Go on, woman of God.
Hallelujah. So I was saying, as you say that the Lord has anointed you, the Lord has anointed us this morning for the people that are watching us this morning. So I remember the story of Cornelius because he's a God of remembrance.
Yes.
So our viewers, I believe most of you, you have been praying and waiting upon the Lord. And most of you, you have been actually faithful in the service to the Lord and unto his people. The same way Cornelius was, because the Bible says he was a devout man and one who feared God with all his household. And he gave his alms generously to the people and prayed to God always.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. This was a man who was waiting upon God, and the Lord decided at that particular time and in that particular day to visit him. Hallelujah.
Hello, caller. Hello. Hello, is there a caller on the line? Go on.
Hallelujah. This is the day of visitation for somebody. Amen. Hallelujah. The same way Cornelius was praying is the same way we have been praying and waiting upon the Lord. And so as Cornelius was praying, Peter was praying as well. And the Lord prepared his heart because he knew that there was somebody that needed to be visited. Hallelujah. Amen. So the Lord this morning has sent us for us to come and bring a word from him to you. Because in verse 6 of Acts chapter 10, the Bible says, hallelujah,
Amen.
That the Lord, by the angel, said to Cornelius, when Peter comes to you, he will tell you what you must do. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that's what the man of God is telling you this morning.
Is there a caller on the line? Hello, is there a caller on the line? Hello, God bless you. Is there a caller on the line? Anyway, let's go on.
Hallelujah. The Lord has sent us to you this morning to tell you what you must do. Hallelujah. Amen. So the word that is coming unto you, receive it with faith.
Yeah, I want you to pray for me because of my work and my marriage children. Yeah, I call from Ghana.
Yes, caller.
My work and my marriage.
Your what? Your marriage and what?
Work.
And your work.
Hello.
Hello, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Calling from Ghana.
From Ghana, yes. You see, our God is omnipresent. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
It doesn't matter. God is not limited by time. He's not limited by geographical location.
I want you to pray for me because of my work.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And then my marriage.
Okay. I pray right now, that storm in your marriage, I command in the mighty name of Jesus. I say, peace be still now. In the mighty name of Jesus, I ask that our God, who is the Prince of Peace, should intervene and bring peace in your marriage. That is what I'm hearing now. The arrows that have been fired into your marriage, I command those fiery arrows to fall to the ground now. I stop them from being active. In the mighty name of Jesus, I command that the fire of God consume those fiery darts now that have brought problem into your marriage. Aha. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Bible says the angel of the Lord encampeth around the righteous. I plead the blood of Jesus upon you now, and you are righteous because of the shed blood of the Lamb. I pray that the angel of the Lord encampeth around you. I put a hedge of fire around your home. No longer will your home be a dwelling place of demons. In the mighty name of Jesus, receive breakthrough now that has been putting a limit to your job. Receive favor concerning that job. Promotion is coming your way. In Jesus' mighty name. Hello, caller.
Hello, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir. Please, I want you to join me in prayer.
Yes.
For God to have mercy and favor me, make a way where there is no way for me.
Mm-hmm. You want him to favor you and make a way for you?
Yeah.
Okay, I pray for you. This God that made a way for the children of Israel, that made them pass through the Red Sea. That is what I'm receiving concerning. It's like you want to pass through the Red Sea now. But I pray that the Lord will wash you in his blood, that you will be justified, and that the Lord, his presence, will abide with you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Bible says even the waters, they saw the presence of God and they fled. That Red Sea that you want to pass through now, I command, let it open now.
Amen.
Let breakthrough come your way this morning. In the
Amen.
Mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Those powers that are incensed against you, that are pursuing you like Egyptians, let the waters, let the Red Sea, let them consume them. Your tormentors that you see today, you will not see them again from today. In the mighty name of Jesus,
Amen.
Receive your breakthrough now.
Amen. Receive deliverance now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Receive a turnaround and a change now. In the mighty name of Jesus. I decree you will prosper. It shall be well with you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every good thing that has been spoken concerning you, when they gave back to you, there were some good things that were spoken about you. Those things have not come to pass yet. They have been hanging. I decree. Every good thing that has been spoken about you, let there be war in the spirit now. Every power of delay, I come against you in the mighty name of Jesus. Let there be a release now. Everything that has been stolen from you, from your birth, let there be a restoration now in the mighty name of Jesus. Everything that has been slow, receive a quickening. Receive a quickening. Let the power of resurrection, let it quicken your life now. I'm hearing the time that you have lost. You have lost so many times. You have lost some years in your life. You can't even account for it. You don't know what you have done with it. Am I speaking to you?
Yeah, you're speaking.
There are some time in your life you can't account for. I pray right now that the Lord will redeem that time now.
Amen.
There will be a redemption of time for you.
Amen.
The God that created the heavens and the earth will turn back the hands of the clock for you. He will restore time that has been stolen to you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
There will be a sevenfold restoration.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I can see that your life has been full of struggles. But from today, the Lord that made Elijah to run and overtake Ahab. Oh Lord, let that be overtaken in the realm of the spirit concerning you now. Let that be speed concerning you now. Let that be overtaken concerning you now. Receive the grace to go and prosper in the mighty name of Jesus. From today, your life will never be the same again. In the mighty name of Jesus. That garment that has been put upon you, I command, let that garment catch fire now.
Hallelujah.
That garment of reproach, let it be destroyed now.
Amen.
That garment of failure, let it be destroyed now.
Amen.
Receive breakthrough in your life now.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
This
is well with you,
Amen.
Sir. In
Jesus'
name. God bless you.
Amen.
Thank you, sir.
Hallelujah.
Is there a caller on the line? I'm going to go on. You see, I'm going to, viewers that you are looking at me, I'm going to teach you another weapon. You see, there are keys to breakthrough. And most people don't know about the ministry of angels. Amen?
Mm.
Angels are the servants of God. They serve God, but as sons of God, we have access to the ministry of angels.
Hello, good morning.
Hello, good morning.
Are you putting me through?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello? What's your name, caller?
Hello?
Hello, good morning. Go on, I can hear you. I think we have lost that call. I want us to know about this ministry of angels. I want us to go to the book of Isaiah, chapter 37. In the book of Isaiah, you will see what angels can do.
I've turned the telly off.
Hello? If you go to the book of Isaiah, chapter 37, man of God, if you can read it for us, Isaiah, chapter 37.
Am I through now?
Verse 36. Hello? 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 Go on. I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Oh, yeah. I could hear you faintly.
Okay. You can hear me faintly. At least you can hear me.
Faintly.
Praise God.
No,
praise God. As long as you
me.
Can hear me, praise God. What do you want the Lord to do for you? Hello. Yes. Go on. Go on. We can hear you.
Okay. Good. Good morning, Pastor.
Good morning. Good morning.
I would just like you to pray for an open heaven for me, please.
To pray for?
Pray for open heaven.
For what?
I just open wanted to pray for me.
Open heavens.
My name is Mojisola Bukola.
Okay. God bless you. Masataya kapasata. Well, you see, when people talk about open heavens, I will tell you some secrets about heaven, the heavens. And why do you want the heavens to open? And what shuts the heavens? Amen. It is good to pray for open heavens.
I'm not hearing well.
You can't hear me well? Can
yeah,
you
I'm
hear me well?
Faintly now here.
Huh?
A bit faintly.
Papa, just carry on.
You see, I'll take you to the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 13. He said, when I shut up the heavens so that there is no rain, or command locusts to devour the land, or send a plague among my people. Why would the Lord do this? It is when there is sin.
Mm.
Amen? So when people are praying for open heavens, that means there's a blockage in the realm of the spirit. There's a blockage. And it's the same thing that happened when the prophet Daniel prayed. And the Bible said he fasted and prayed for 21 days.
Mm.
But when angel Gabriel came, he said the first day you prayed, God has answered.
Mm.
But there was a delay. Mm. The prince of Persia held on to the answer. Mm. Amen.
Mm.
And until God realized that Daniel was still praying.
Mm.
God has answered first day. Second day he was still praying. Third day he was still pulling. Mm. Fourth day, fifth day.
Yeah.
God now had to send. He said, I have sent my word. What is holding my word? He now sends Michael, the archangel. He now sent Michael to go and meet angel Gabriel. And both of them warred against the prince of Persia, and they prevailed. And he now said, I have come to watch that word, to make sure you receive your answer. So somebody is looking at me now. All the answer to your prayers that you have been received, that have been delayed, they have been held up in the realm of the spirit. The powers in the realm of the spirit, the money powers that are holding on to your answer, that are holding on to your breakthrough, that are making the heavens to be shut. Right now, I bind those powers in the mighty name of Jesus. Because I'm seated in heavenly places, above every principality, above every power of darkness, above spiritual wickedness in high places. Right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, I bind every power of darkness. You, prince of the power of the air, I bind you right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, I dispatch angels now. Let there be an ascending and descending of angels as you are looking at me. Let there be an ascending and descending of angels. Begin to receive your answers now. Let answers be dispatched. Everybody that is looking at me and your prayers are delayed, begin to receive them now. Let angels begin to deliver your answers. Let them begin to deliver the answer to the prayers you have prayed that have been delayed. Receive your answers now and begin. You have to testify.
I receive it.
In the mighty name of the numbers on the screen, I want to hear about your testimonies. Because I know that, look, the Lord is doing something. Angels have been dispatched because of you. There's an ascending and descending of angels. In the mighty name of Jesus, the heavens are open now. I have declared the heavens open above you. And the earth will bring forth its increase. No longer will you sow and will you get tons. There will be increase in the mighty name of Jesus. That desolate wilderness, I speak to that desolate wilderness that I see you in now. That it becomes a fertile ground. From today, you'll be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. In the mighty name of Jesus. God bless you.
Thank you.
The fire of God is here. The presence of God is here. And in the presence of God, there is liberty. I don't want to know how big the mountain is. I don't want to know how big that problem is. We serve a God above all gods. We serve a God that is bigger than any problem. We serve a God that is bigger than any mountain. The Bible says in his presence, The mountains, they melt like wax. No matter what that problem is, I don't care how long that problem has been there. Because we come in the name of the mighty God. Because we come with the presence of God. Because the presence of God is here. And that presence of God is going into your homes right now. Let every mountain begin to melt. In Jesus' name.
That's the color on the line. Hello, color.
Hello, Pastor.
Good morning. How are you?
Good morning.
Fine, thank you.
Yeah, what's your name? Where are you calling from?
My name is Mommy Femi.
Okay.
I want to pray for my children, Femi.
And you are calling from?
I'm calling from Wales.
From Wales. Okay, you want to, your children to be prayed for?
Yes, and one of them is called Femi, the other one. Well, I just want God to pray. I want the man of God to pray for them, please.
Okay, man of God. Do you have a specific...
Concerning their studies, for them to... Okay. Yeah.
What is your
for
name?
For them to excel in their what studies.
What is your name? Hello?
My name is Bruce.
Rose.
Okay. I pray for your children. You see, I'm going to call upon our God. He's the God of Daniel. You see, among his mates... They said, the Bible says, God gave him the grace. He was 10 times more intelligent than his mates. And I pray right now for your children, that the hand of God will come upon them in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let them receive favor of God and favor of men in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. I put the mark of the blood upon this one.
In the name of Jesus.
That spirit of rebellion.
In the name of
That spirit of Belial.
In the name of
That is upon this land that you are. Will not go into those children.
In the name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray for those children. They will be great.
In the name
they will be mighty. They will grow in the fear of God.
Yes,
in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The spirit of wisdom will be upon them.
Yes.
The seven spirits of God. I release it upon them now. The spirit of wisdom.
Yes.
Understanding,
yes.
The spirit of might, the fear of God, the spirit of God, the spirit of counsel. We come upon those children in the mighty name of Jesus. There's a turnaround and a change upon those children now. Every lot in their life,
in the name of Jesus.
Let there be a separation right now.
Amen.
Any friend that they have that is not of God, I separate them right now in the realm of the spirit, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, our Father and our God.
Yes, Lord.
It shall be well with you, Mother.
Amen.
And it shall be well with your children.
Amen.
Amen.
You and your children, you will inherit this land.
Amen. Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You and your children, you will inherit this land.
Amen.
Amen.
Your children, the Bible says, the children of the righteous, they shall be great and they shall be mighty.
Amen.
So shall it be for you and your children.
Amen.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
It shall be well with you. God bless you.
Amen, sir.
In Jesus' name.
God bless you. And take the numbers that is on the screen. You can call him later on when we finish, okay? God bless you, Baba. Yes, man of God, this is powerful. I mean, it's so exciting what the Lord is doing.
Amen.
Yes, hello, call out the line. Hello?
Yeah, hello.
Yes, what's your name, please? Where are you calling from?
My name is Catherine.
And you are calling from?
I'm calling from Oxford. Oxford.
Oxford, okay. Now, what's your prayer request?
About my papers and my children.
How long has your papers been in the home office? How long?
More than 16 years.
More than 16 years. Wow. Where did it go?
More than 16 years.
Okay. You see?
Yep.
There's a woman in the Bible. I perceive in my spirit. You have prayed. Different people have prayed. But because of the God, the
the God that has called me will honor your faith this morning.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Today is your
Shiloh. Today is your Shiloh. Yes. Today is your Shiloh.
Hallelujah.
Namba shikaba suntaba.
In the name of Jesus.
Because I'm seated with the Lord in heavenly places,
yes,
above every principality and above every power.
Yes.
Amen.
There is a power in that home office.
In the name of Jesus.
And we have powers over that power. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
There's a power over this nation. But the power we operate in is the power of the King of the universe.
Yes.
And I take authority right now.
In the name of
Jesus.
You
see, the same power that looked for the axe head that was thrown in the water and brought it to the surface. Wherever they have hid your fire now, I command, I dispatch angels now. Let them go and dig out your fire now. Let the favor of God come upon that fire.
Amen.
The favor of God upon you.
Amen.
The favor of God and the favor of men.
Amen.
I plead the blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
I plead the blood of Jesus
the
right
blood
now.
Blood of Jesus.
Whatever they are, I can hear some power saying no. Mamba shikandabu basete, mamba shikabase, mandere bubaba sekete. Because it is written that he will confirm the words of his servant, the prophet. O Lord, mashikabase teke musuntabaya. I pray right now that every accusation against you,
in the name of Jesus,
in the mighty name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
let the blood of Jesus wipe it away.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And I pray that the mercy of God,
yes,
that override every judgment,
yes,
that mercy we speak for you
in
now.
In the name of Jesus.
That mercy we sort out your papers.
In the name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Ma, let me ask you, where do you fellowship? What church do you go to? Can you hear me?
I fellowship in one of the churches in Oxford.
You do what?
One of the churches
what
in Oxford.
What is it called? What is that church called?
Christ Army.
Huh?
Christ Army.
First Army.
Christ Army.
Christ Army.
Can you hear me?
Yep.
Now.
Yep.
This is what I am. This is what is coming to my spirit.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Now, I'm not telling you to give me anything.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to go to that house of God.
Yeah.
Go and buy something that will be used in praising God there. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Go and buy something that will be used mightily in the house of God. Can you hear me now? Go to the pastor and say, Lord, Pastor, I want to, what need is in the house?
Yeah, I'll do that.
What is need is in the house of God. Go and buy it. And when you buy it, you will see what will happen. Amen. The Lord will work wonders in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And it shall be well with you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Release your breakthrough now.
Yes.
I declare the doors open.
In the name
you see,
of Jesus.
Obedience is the key to breakthrough. As you obey that word, you will receive your breakthrough. And that man of God, you see, grace comes from up to down. As you do that thing and that man of God pray for you, something will be activated in the realm of the spirit.
In the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Wow.
God bless you.
God bless you. Take his number and you can speak to him afterwards. God bless you. Bye-bye. Well, I know that there's a lot of calls on the queue and people want to be prayed for. But as we promise that you will be prayed for, I can still hear the calls are coming in. But please take the numbers that are on the screen, the two numbers that are on the screen, so that as soon as we're off air, you can pick up your phone and call. And this is so exciting because, you know, before we know it now, this is 4 a.m. already. And the time goes so fast like that. And I know we can remain here even till another 4 a.m.
Yes.
It's not a problem at all. But because we are in that time and we've got to work according to time, And of course, because the Bible says the spirit of the prophet is subject to the prophet. Now, we will pray for you, but we're running up at the moment so for this session, and you can take the numbers and the details that is on the screen and call the man of God. Have time. You know, he might call you, he might ask you, make appointment to see him for counseling or for prayer. You know, whatever it is that the Lord laid in his heart to do in request to your, or in meeting the request you have brought up, just, you know that the Lord is faithful. Yes, let's have a two minutes round up before
okay.
we go. Yeah.
What I'm going to say is that because we are going to go off here, as he has said, take the numbers, and if you are in London, if we are in Croydon, come to 82 London Road, is the CVA building, 82 London Road, Croydon. CRO2TB, that's the postcode. And if you're in the city of Portsmouth, look for Charles Dickens Center. It is in Lake Road, Portsmouth. The postcode is PO14DY, and you meet this powerful woman of God there, and they will minister unto you. But I know that the Lord will do awesome things, because it is not only in prayer, you need to be taught.
Mm-hmm.
It is knowledge that gives power.
Amen.
We want to teach you what we know so that you can grow like us.
Mm.
Amen. It is knowledge that is power. Amen. So before we go, let me just pray for you. If you are at home, just raise up your hand. You are not raising your hand to any man. When we raise up our hand, we are raising up our hands to God. It's a form of submission. And say, Father, you see, as these ones that have raised their hands in obedience, they have not raised their hands to me, but they've raised it to you. They are saying that they are submitting to you as the King of Kings, as the Lord of Lords, the Alpha and the Omega. Father, as their faces are different, so is their heart desires. Father, I pray, you are beautiful for all situations. Meet everybody at the point of their need. Let your presence go right now into their homes. Your word says, in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and that Word is God. That Word became a living, became flesh, and it became the light of all men. And that light shines, and darkness cannot comprehend it. Father, let your light go now into every home now.
Amen.
Let it permeate. Let it go into every home. Let it outshine every darkness now.
Amen.
I see somebody, you have been crying. You have been crying in your closet. And I pray, the same God that turned the waters of Mara that was bitter to be sweet, let that same God turn your tears into celebration now.
Amen.
That secret, those secret Jesus tears, man, you are crying.
Amen.
Let it turn to public celebration.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I change your seasons right now.
Amen.
It will be harvest time.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
It will be breakthrough for you.
Amen.
When the light of God shines, every plan of the enemy shall be exposed.
Amen.
I cancel every plan of the enemy.
Amen.
This month you will testify.
Amen.
This is your year.
Amen.
This is your hour.
Amen.
You are moving forward. I break every limitation.
Amen.
I break every bondage.
Amen.
I break every shackle and every
hallelujah
in the mighty name of
Amen.
Jesus. Receive your breakthrough now.
Amen.
You are blessed.
Amen.
The favor of God comes upon you.
Amen.
You are unstoppable.
Amen.
Go and prosper.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, our Father and our God.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen. Well, this is awesome. We see the power of God moving into your home for a purpose, and I'm so excited. Now, I know, if you do want to get in touch with the man of God, or you want to listen to his teachings, he's here on Olive TV every Wednesday. Every Wednesday, 10 to 11 in the morning. 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. every Wednesday morning. You cannot miss it. There, you can listen to his teachings. And of course, all the expositions of the Word of God. And all that you need, just find him on here on Olive TV. Whatever you are watching, make it a date. Note the time. It's 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. every Wednesday. He is here on Olive Television from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. And today, I know that your life will never remain the same.
Amen.
As I said, you can just keep, you know, call. He will be here for a few minutes before he leaves. You can call the numbers that is on the screen. And some of you that are still on the queue in the studio is going to pray for you. Listen, whatever you do, I want you to get ready. If you are watching right now and you have not given your life to Jesus, amen, your life is at risk. You are a living dead person. Mm. And I want you to pray this prayer with me quickly before we go. I want you to say, Lord Jesus, I have heard your word today. I acknowledge that I am a sinner and I have sinned. Lord Jesus, forgive me my sins. Come into my life. Be my Lord and my Savior. From today, I give my life to you. Grant me the power to live for you all the days of my life. Thank you, Lord Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. If you have prayed this prayer, I say congratulations, because now you are a child of God according to the promises of God. And four things you must do as angels are rejoicing in heaven for your decision that you have made now. Four things you must do. Number one, you must read your Bible. Began from the book of St. John's Gospel. Read it, study it, read it, study it. And the Holy Spirit will minister who Jesus is to you and strengthen your faith. Number two, you must pray. Whenever you pray, you are stirred up to read the word. Whenever you read the word, you are stirred up to pray. And number three, pick up your phone, tell somebody what the Lord has done for you. And then number four, look for a living church, a local living church, a church that is born, that teaches born again, that the Spirit of God is moving there and the Word of God is properly taught, balanced. Look for that church, identify yourself with them, tell them what has happened to you. If you do these four things, you will grow in nurture and admonition of the Lord. And if you do need any further help, give us a call. And I know that the Lord is going to strengthen you. Don't go away, because we are on. The next program is also for you. God bless you and stay tuned. God bless you.